Welcome, welcome, welcome. Hello, beautiful. And welcome to the Madison Reed Hair Colour House Party. We're coming to you live on Zoom. Hello to our Zoom audience. And we're coming on Facebook Live from our bathrooms and from our kitchens, colouring our hair together. And we're from all over the US. We've got people in Hawaii. We've got people in New York. We've got people on the West Coast. I'm in Dallas. We are a community. And what we love more than anything else is to share our experiences and to share our knowledge about hair color. We're here to help you, to answer your questions about hair color, and to make sure that you leave our house party feeling comfortable and confident about coloring your hair. Now today we're getting double the fun because we're partnering with STYLECASTER, a fashion, beauty and lifestyle hub that invites readers to discover and express themselves. Outside opinions be damned, and we love that. So tonight we have STYLECASTER beauty writer Elizabeth Denton here, who will provide tips on how to really shout about your fabulous makeover that you're going to be achieving with Madison Reed and how you can tell the world. So hello, Elizabeth.
Hi, everyone.
Elizabeth's on the West Coast, so she's going to be talking to us later. Now, for everybody who joins us here tonight, we're going to be donating $1 to Direct Relief. They do so much good in the world, and we love partnering with them. Camera's on because there's a contest tonight. So we're giving away a full colour experience. Now, that's going to be by consultation. And if you would like to be part of that, then you need to turn your camera on so that we can see you, we can see your beautiful hair, and we can also answer any questions that you might want to throw at us. We're going to give a full permanent color or a full color experience from Madison Reed to that lucky winner that we're going to be announcing at the end. So stay with us and turn your camera on. Now, we've got somebody here tonight who absolutely knows what they're doing when it comes to colour. And she's going to show us that if you want to change your mind, then that actually might be okay. So, Siobhan, do you want to give us a wave?
Hi, everyone. Aloha from Kauai, where it's 3 p.m. I know we're cross time everywhere. I'm happy to be with you all and teach you how to colour your hair.
So Siobhan's going to be showing us a real transformation this evening, or this afternoon, if you happen to be in Hawaii, because she's going to look very different later. But let's get to that. Now, a little bit of housekeeping. So if you're on Facebook Live, just type your questions in as normal, and our Facebook moderator will get those over to us. So Siobhan and I will be answering questions all the way through. So please try for one question each. There's lots of you and we want to get to as many people as possible. So make it your hairiest one and we'll do our best to answer it. If you don't get your question answered, don't worry about that. Right at the end, we'll be giving you an email where you can email us. Those emails will go directly to Siobhan and she will be able to answer your question herself. So a little bit of one-on-one for those of you who we don't get to. Now, in order to ask your question, what we're going to ask you to do to our Zoom audience is to rename yourself. If you're called Susan's iPad, for example, go to those three little dots at the top of your screen and you can call yourself whatever you'd like us to call you. That makes it easier if we call on you to answer your question. If you would like to ask a question and you're on your computer, you need to go down to the reaction button on the computer and click on that, and then you'll be able to raise your hand. On your phone, go to your three little dots and you'll be able to raise your hand there. What we'll do is answer your questions in the order in which they come to us. So don't worry, if there's lots of questions, we will try and get to you. So just be patient with us. Everybody's going to be on mute. So we'll unmute you when we come to answer your questions. So sit tight, sit back, relax. We've got lots to show you, tips and tricks from the top. And we're all about empowerment here at Madison Reed. So we're going to give you the knowledge you need to do what you'd like to do. So enough from me. Siobhan, tell us what transformation you'll be affecting tonight.
Yes, you got it. Okay, I'm really excited about this because a lot of what we do, I've done quite a few hair color house parties where I'm coloring my own hair. And a lot of what we do is maintenance, roots, you know, gray coverage, roots and gloss, things like that. What I'm excited about today is I'm going to do an all over color. So I am going to look different leaving here than I do right now. So I don't know about all of you, like I can kind of peek over and see my little gallery view and see your beautiful faces, but you know, by a show of hands, does anybody else fight against the trend of going lighter in the summer, darker in the winter? Because I always do the exact opposite. And I don't know why, but I always want to go a little bit more brunette in the summer. Maybe it's because my skin is more bronze, or I don't know, maybe I don't have a reason and it's just what I feel compelled to do. But in the winter and autumn, that's when I like to have more highlighted hair. So I'm today going to go totally against the grain and do all over and show you a couple things that you might not necessarily know about doing an all over color. Because there's a little bit of a myth that all over color is the easiest thing you can do because you literally just put color all over your hair. And it can be, but it can give you kind of unwanted results. So I'm going to show you some key things that are going to make your life easier and more beautiful when you're doing an all over color on your hair. So I know you want to get straight to the action and you're sick of talking. I get that. So I am going to start with the application and then I'm going to talk about the whys and all of that while we're doing it. Does that sound like a good plan? Okay. So I am going to use, I've got the Ulta box here because I'm traveling and picking up a color kit at Ulta is easiest for me. If you get the kit from madisonreed.com, it'll look a little different, but all the contents are exactly the same. So the color I'm using on my new growth is going to be different than the color I'm using on my highlighted stuff. And again, we'll talk about that as I go. So everything you need is in the box. So you don't have to have extras. I happen to have a bowl and brush just because I like it. That's a nice to have, that's not a need to have. So I'll show you that, but I'll also show you just how to apply with the bottle so that you don't have to buy extra stuff. I already took the gloves out of here. They're on my hands, but usually there's gloves here. See, everything you need, shampoo, conditioner, barrier cream, everything is in here. So I am going to get mixing and I am going to mix my two kits now. This is gonna look pretty different than my root color, but I'm using the Luca Light Golden Blonde on my ends. So I'm using two different kinds of brown because I want a natural effect. So I'm gonna mix them both at the same time so that this is ready for me when I go from here to here, okay? And while I'm doing that, Susan, can you give us some, maybe just a little bit of like basic 101 information about why we use two different shades when we're doing an all over color?
Oh yes, there's nothing I like better than talking about hair color, as most of you know. So Siobhan has two different colors of hair. She has hair which is dark that we can see at the root. In fact, some of that is hair which is natural and some of that is hair which is colored. She also has on the ends of her hair, you can very much see the lightened areas. And for those of you who are faithful attendees of our house, hair color house party, you will have seen Siobhan do her own highlights with our fabulous Lightworks kit. And she's done an amazing job, but she's changed her mind. And oftentimes we think that that's one of the big fears about hair color, that perhaps we can't change our mind and maybe it is going to be difficult to change. So therefore, we might not want to dip our toe in the water to begin with. So we're here to tell you that actually you can change that very easily. There are a few things that you do need to know though. So first of all, usually when we color hair, what we're striving for is for the hair color to be darker and flatter at the roots. So in other words, a little bit darker, closer to your natural color perhaps, and without warmth at the root area. And then on the ends, what we like to see is some warmth and to have it a little bit lighter. And think about it. Those of you who have children, or think about your own hair. When you go to the beach and your hair lightens naturally in the sun, that's what always happens. You always get a darker, flatter root and a lighter, brighter, warmer end. And that's when hair always looks natural when it's colored in that way. So that's exactly what Siobhan is doing now. She's going to go in with your permanent color at the root, cover any grays that she has. They are there. She's hiding them. She's hiding them very expertly, but they are absolutely there. And how long, Siobhan, has it been since you colored your hair last time?
Since I did my roots, it's probably been a little over a month.
Okay.
So I do have some sparklers in there. I'm about 15% gray. My gray hairs are kind of fine, so they don't really poke out so much, but I know so many of our clients have gray hair that is also a different texture, so it loves to show off and just like stand up right on end like a little unicorn horn, and it's like, hi, I'm here. Mine kind of lay down flat, so, but trust me, they're there.
So you're one of the lucky ones. 4 weeks is about right, isn't it? 4 to 6 weeks is what we would usually recommend. I know that's what I tell my clients. Ooh, look at that.
Okay, so this is super cool. This is called barrier cream, and it comes in our kits. It's not something separate you have to buy. This is a skin protector so that you don't get hair dye on your skin. If you have colored your own hair at home, you know that you get this lovely sometimes dark colored headband around your skin that tells the whole world that you just colored your hair. And that's optional. You don't have to have that. You can use this barrier cream. Here's kind of a little tip. Keep it on the skin and try to keep, don't be messy with it. Do use a little caution here, because if you get the barrier cream on the hair, it will block the grays from covering. Okay, so I am mixed. I've got my darker color here. I have put my lighter color way over there on my sink so I don't confuse them, because mistakes happen. So remember I said I'm gonna show you two different ways to apply color. We're gonna talk bowl and brush, and we're gonna talk bottle. I'm gonna start with bottle, because if you don't have a bowl and brush, this can be the easiest. So I'm gonna go from back here. The reason I don't start here is because as color warms up, it can drip, and I don't want it starting at my forehead. I want it back here, and then I have more room to play with it. So I'm doing zigzag across the top, right? It's that much color. It should be thick. It should be like yogurt or cake frosting. Like, you should really, really see it. And then I'm massaging it in with my fingers. And then this is another thing that I think, you know, a lot of us don't know or don't pay attention to when we're coloring our own hair, is the pattern that you do things in. Try to keep it neat. So I'm using this nozzle to go back and create my parting, right? And now I'm going to flip it over, and I have this nice, neat section to put on more color across the root. There we go. And then I'm going to work it in. Now, you might notice that I'm not being super picky about where this stops. The reason is I don't have I'm attempting to go deep in all of this. So I'm going to pull this color down further. So you don't have to be so careful where it stops if you're doing something like this, where you know you're going kind of all over anyway. And then the bottle that we give you at Madison Reed is no drip. So you can use it to section out your hair and part your hair without it getting everywhere. But if you are a bowl and brush user, or you've always seen your colorist do a bowl and brush and you're curious about it, I'm going to show you how to do that too. So I've emptied that into my bowl and brush, and I'm going to use the handle to create a skinny little section, flip it over, and now I'm going to paint it. And what a lot of us like about bowl and brush, again, you don't have to have the bowl and brush. It's just kind of fun. And it lets you be a little bit more specific, because you've got that really skinny end to the brush, and it just gives you a nice neat line. And then you can feel where that color and the bristles are hitting your scalp, so you know you're getting really good saturation. So I'm a fan of the bowl and brush, but do not feel like you need one to have a successful color application. Okay, so I'm moving along. I am wanting to, Susan, unless you have something that you wanted to say right now or a question you wanted to take, I would love to talk as I work about why I'm doing two different colors to create an all over color.
Yes, go right ahead. I just want to remind everybody that if you'd like to ask a question, you can go down to your reactions button. If you click on that, you'll be able to raise your hand. And then any questions that you have for Siobhan, you'll be able to ask them. We'll get to you in turn. So go for it, Siobhan. We are all in. Why?
Okay, and before I launch into that, can everyone see pretty clearly the sectioning and how I'm getting? Okay, great. I'm seeing nods, so that is helpful. Okay, so it is actually pretty rare that we ever use one single color all over a client's hair. The reason for that is because you can see that different parts of my hair are obviously going to need different things. The darkest stuff, what I'm calling the new growth, all that dark natural before the highlights, is going to be healthier. It's going to have some gray. It's already darker. And so this color that's going to make the top part look best is probably going to make the highlighted part look too dark, too inky, too wiggy. And even when you're getting an all over color, even when you decide I want to be an all over brunette, you might still want it to be a dimensional soft brunette. You might not want the color on your roots the exact same as the color on your ends. Now, if that's a choice, if you like that's your aesthetic, you just love a nice, beautiful jet black hair beginning to end, you do you, that's totally fine. But if you're going for something that you're trying to kind of convince the world is a little bit more natural, then using two colors is a good way to go. So the color that I'm using on my highlighted areas is a golden light brown because I want it to look natural. I am kind of trying to convince the world that this is natural. So I'm gonna use an ash up at the top and a gold down at the bottom. And I wanna talk about those tones and why we would do something like that. So I'm gonna look over and see by a show of hands, you don't have to use the reaction button, you can literally raise your hand. How many of you are brunettes where your hair always turns red or brassy or orange in the sun? Okay, like every single brunette. The reason you have that problem is that red is the natural underlying color of brown. There's nothing you can do about it. You can't change it. It's just how color is built. That's how the melanin is in your hair. So most brunettes fight with orange tones and red tones. So I'm using an ash brown. This has like violet in it and bluish tones in it. It's not going to look violet and blue on my hair because it's fighting the orange and red that already live there. Does that make sense? So this is why if you're a brunette and you've ever bought something that says hints of gold and you're like, why is my hair copper now? It's because you added a little bit of gold to what already has the tendency to turn copper, especially as it fades out, especially in the sun. So very often we'll recommend brunettes use an ash, even if ash isn't your desired result. You're not trying to look ash, you're trying to look neutral. But we know that your hair is hiding some red underneath it, and we're trying to save you from that experience. So therefore, I showed you all a box in the beginning of this that's called smoky brown or ash brown. It's not gonna look ash on my hair, and you'll see that in the after photos. Now, if I take that ash brown and I put it on all this highlighted hair that has bleach on it, it's going to look inky, dark, and kind of unwell. It'll kind of look greenish or swampy. Like it just won't be pretty and natural. So what I'm going to do here is I'm using one level lighter. So this is medium brown. This will be light brown. And instead of using an ash, I'm going to use a gold. And that's going to make this is gonna look neutral, and this is gonna look neutral with a little bit of gold. So you gotta kind of think, what's going on this hair and what does it need? What's going on this hair and what does it need? And it's not always the same. But here's the beauty about it. I'm gonna do this one time with these two different colors. I don't have to do this every single time. Once I get the canvas evened out, then I can do just my roots, let this kind of fade, and then I'll be using roots and gloss. So I know it might look a little bit laborious right now, like, oh gosh, you gotta get two different kits and two different things. It's a one time only. Once you're evened out, you don't have to keep doing this. Okay, Susan, I'm gonna turn around and do my best to show me touching up my roots in the back. You guide me on how well you can see me.
Fabulous, well, you're doing okay. You're doing amazing. We can see very well right now.
And we get a ton of questions about how do I see the back? You don't ever see the back. You're gonna go by feel. and you're just going to do your best. And if you miss a hair, you're just going to go in there and massage it with your fingers and everything's going to be okay. I mean, we're professional colorists. We don't ever always get every hair. You're going to be fine.
I think the thing to remember is that where this will help you, color feels cold on your head. So if you're feeling the cold color, then that's a good thing, because what that means is that you're going to be putting it on your scalp. And you can see what Siobhan's doing is she's using the end of her brush, because she's still using a bowl and brush. If you're using a bottle here, you'd be able to use the nozzle to do that sectioning. And what the secret of being able to do a clean section like the one she's doing is that when you touch the scalp with the end of that brush, you keep contact with it. You can't touch a little bit and then not keep contact, because then you won't be taking a clean section. So you can see that what she's doing is nice clean sections, plenty of color always. One of the biggest things that we hear is that there's not enough color on, right, Siobhan?
Mm-hmm. Gotta slap it on really thick. And then now that I've applied that with the brush, then I just go in with my gloved hand under the highlighted part, leave that out so you're not gunking any of that up, and then massage it in. Just do this in the root so that you know you're getting it all, right? I'm staying away from the highlights. I'm just letting them hang out, but I'm just kind of massaging through so that I can feel that it's touching everything. Okay, I'm gonna go to the other side. I'm gonna try to, I'm right-handed, so you gotta bear with me here.
Well done, you're doing great. And I think the thing to note is that what Siobhan's doing is trying to apply the color through just the roots of her hair. And then with a nice clean section, she's able to do that. That's when it's important for you, if you're using two colors like this, to take nice clean sections and to just kind of divide the head up into what's a workable amount for you. Sometimes people ask us, well, if my hair's short, how am I going to be able to section off like that? The answer is don't. Because once you've got color on your hair, it's much easier to section it than it is before you've got the color on. Also, if you're doing this kind of thing, it's actually easier to work with hair that's not clean. So we would recommend that you wouldn't wash your hair on the day that you're going to color it. Wash it the day before, or even the day before that, because it helps you be able to deal with your hair, to kind of manipulate it better. And for those of you who do go to salons, that's a good point, because oftentimes people will come in with clean hair thinking, oh, I don't want my hairdresser to see that my hair was not clean. Well, you don't need to.
Yeah, we've seen it all. We don't care. Come in with your dirty hair and make our job a little easier. And we're never judging your unwashed hair. Like, just like you guys aren't judging my two-day dirty hair right now.
So okay. Siobhan, can I just answer a quick question from Julie?
Yes, Julie, I would love that.
Facebook has asked, what color I have on my hair. Well, that's nice. Thank you for asking, Julie. So my color is Verona. It's actually 6NAC. That's the number and the lettering. What that is, it's Verona, if you can see on my hair a little bit. It's a dark brown, but it has both ash and copper tones in there. So I am a natural brunette, but I like my red. So I'm going to be encouraging that. And that's what Verona helps me to do. I've also got through the ends of my hair a little bit of a redder tone. That's Amaretto Gloss. So I hope that answers your question. I like to use the perfect pair. And those of you who've been on Hair Color House Party will have seen that. So,
okay, so let me show you really quick something before I ruin this visual, because I'm going to. You saw that I just put all this all over my roots and I brought it pretty far down and I massaged it in, and I was generous with the product. I slapped it on there pretty good. I still have this much left in my bottle. Okay. I don't love throwing away products that I purchased into the trash. So I would much rather put that on my head than put it in the garbage. And I just don't even care if I need it or not, because I'm going to use it because I spent my money on it. So if you're like me, you just empty the contents of your bottle right in your bowl. And what I want you to do at this point is go through. So, okay, let's say my roots are on, all this stuff is wet. I could move on now, but instead of moving on, I'm gonna use up all my product. Especially if you're dealing with grays, go back through and get to your hairline and weigh those bad boys down, because we all know that resistant grays, especially grays with an attitude, they'll kind of pop up out of the color, like they're strong and thick and coarse, and you literally want to weigh them down with product. The other thing that we do, this is a pro tip, this is something no one ever tells you when you're doing it at home, but we do it in salons, is we do something called cross check. So you saw that I took skinny, nice little horizontal sections this way, right, as I was applying it. Before I set my timer, which I'm about to do, I'm going to go in the opposite direction, and I'm going to look for any missed spots. So if I did horizontal, I'm going to do vertical. And so I'm going to just split these and take a look in the mirror and go, oh, is anything dry in there? Okay, slap on a little bit more color. This is one of the things that is happening to you in a professional salon that you might not be doing at home, but it really behooves you to just double check yourself, because we all miss things.
Well, okay. And it's a great time to do this, isn't it, Siobhan? Because at this point, you see where the hair has started to look darker, and the color is darkening on the hair. So that's what we call oxidation. That's totally normal. That's what color does. So if you're darkening your hair, and even sometimes when you're lightening it, you will notice that the color starts to look dark on there. That's the time to cross check, because that's when you can really see where any dry spots are or where any white spots are, because there's no color there.
Okay, Susan, do we have a question waiting?
Well, I'd like to remind everybody that if you do want to ask a question, then go down to your reactions button and you can raise your hand. And then when you do raise your hand, we will answer those questions. So if you've got anything burning to ask Siobhan or anyone else for that matter, then go ahead and ask that question. We will ask to unmute you at the time and you'll be able to ask it.
Okay, Siobhan. We do have a couple. Okay, let me just say this real quick so that you can take your next question. Okay. And I can catch the drip that I just got on my floor. Okay, so I wanted to point out, I use this one bowl and brush. I'm not gonna get out a second one. I'm gonna give this a quick rinse and I'm gonna put my other color right in here. And I'm also gonna use the bottle as well to show you both ways. So while I do that, Susan, you can totally grab a question and then I'll come right back.
Gorgeous. Okay, so Stormy, I can see that you are asking a question. You've got your hands raised. So I'm going to ask to unmute you, darling. Are you there, Stormy? Are you there, Stormy? Can I see you? I'm going to ask to unmute you. You are not there. I cannot see you. Okay, so Mercedes. Going to ask you a question, darling. Are you there?
Hello. Yes, I am here.
Hi.
Thank you again. My question now, Siobhan just did her highlights 2 weeks ago. How frequently can you do these color treatments before you start to damage your hair?
Ooh, now that's a fantastic question. The answer to that, as most things hair color related are, it depends. So okay. It depends on what you are trying to do, and it depends on where you are coming from. So in Siobhan's case, what she has is hair which is already lightened. It's super easy to darken hair, super easy. Okay. What's difficult to do and what's often more damaging to do, Mercedes, is to lighten it. So depending on what you've got underneath there. So here, Siobhan's probably going to be doing her hair a little bit of a favor. Her hair is lightened already. She's going to be darkening it. That means we're going to get shine. That means we're going to get a nice soft gold brown color through those ends. Okay. If she decided next week, which, you know, would not be the first time, that she wanted her highlights back again, what we would probably be recommending her to do is to approach that quite gently, because what's underneath there is hair which is already lightened. So, and this is one of the things that we work really hard on at Madison Reed, because we have a questionnaire on our website. If you've not been on the website, then that's one way that you can approach your formulation. We also have a color crew who are on hand, because what we're always wanting to understand is what the history of your hair is.
Okay.
So depending on what's happened before, it may or may not be advisable to do the step that you're contemplating after. Mm-hmm. The short answer is, you can, depending on what you want to do, you can do whatever you like, but we need to understand what's happened beforehand. So,
okay.
Can I add something real quick to that? Because that's a great question. And I had a feeling, you know, I'm glad you addressed that, because it was one of my talking points that I forgot as I started moving through my hair. You'll also notice that once all of this, so my timer for my roots is 35 minutes, right? Because I'm not covering a ton of gray, and 35 is the standard. Now, that's already ticking. And so this that I'm putting on these ends, this is only going to be on here about 20 minutes. Does that make sense? So I wouldn't process my more delicate, porous, lots of miles on them ends for the same time that I would process my roots, because to your point, that's a little scary, right? And okay. then,
that makes sense.
Yes. Oh, see, dripping on my floor. And then the other thing that I want to call out too is, that's why I kind of brought up, like, I'm only doing this once. After I do this full canvas color, I'm switching right back over to gloss for maintenance. If your hair is breaking, if your hair is looking a little sad, if your hair is having some issues, you know, waiting a little bit longer before you do a full color over highlights is probably advisable. My hair is kind of behaving pretty well, but thank you for bringing up the hair integrity question.
Okay. Well, thank you.
Thank you, Mercedes. So I've got some other people. Let's see, Stormy. Can I ask to unmute you again? Can we see if we can find you now, Stormy? I'm going to ask to unmute you, and she's still not there. Okay, let's go to Bridget. Bridget.
Hey, Susan, really quick before we go to Bridget, can I throw a little thing in? Because I'll probably be done with this. I remember how when I started the front, I was the top, my new growth, I was doing it from the front and working back. Now that I'm doing the ends, I'm kind of working from the back forward, which you're probably noticing. I'm taking the pieces back. And the reason is because I start back here, I run it through the ends, and then I can get it out of my way a little bit as I keep going, because having wet color treated hair around my face is going to be a mess. So if you're wondering why I'm going in a different direction, that is why. And if you're not wondering, that's okay too.
And actually, keep your eye on Siobhan, because as she's applying that color, you'll be able to see those thirsty ends drinking it in.
Okay, Susan, so you're a true friend. You always tell me exactly what's going on with myself.
So Bridget, let me see if I can find you. I'm going to ask to unmute you, my love, and I can see your ask your question. Hi. Hello.
Okay. Sorry. Hi, Susan. It's been years since I colored my hair. I think I did it just once, maybe 10 years or 20 years ago. So I'm not really used to hair coloring. So I just wanted to ask, because Siobhan said you have to use up the product. I'm just wondering, do you have to use up the product? Can you use it later? I don't know. Maybe instead of putting all that on your hair, maybe your hair does not need it anymore, can you keep it and use it later? I don't know.
Excellent.
I'm not used to hair coloring. That's what I'm asking.
There's lots of people wanting to know the answer to that question. I hate waste myself, and I know Siobhan does, and that's why she uses it all up, because it's already mixed and you can't keep it. If it's already mixed, then you can't keep it. What you can do, though, and if you're a little bit frugal, which I girl after my own heart, I'm totally that girl. If you feel that you're not going to use the full tube, then just mix half. You can always mix a bit more if you run out, right? So just mix half. The easiest way to do that is to invert your applicator bottle so that all the activator goes to the bottom. And then use a bowl and brush. That's what you're going to have to do. Non-metallic, and ideally Madison Reed, because obviously we provide everything for you. Just put half of the tube into the bowl and then put half of the activator with that. Mix it together, good to go. So I would do that. You can always start with half and mix up a bit more. if you think you're not going to need.
But once it's mixed, it's game over. Once it's mixed, you got to use it all. You can't like refrigerate it or save it or anything. So yeah, don't forget to.
And Bridget, we get that question all the time. So thank you for that.
Thank you.
Can really quick before you go to your next question, the other thing I wanted to point out is I've got all this darker color here. I've got this lighter color here. So maybe you're wondering what happens at the midpoint where the two colors connect? Does it matter? Am I gonna have a weird line? So no. So remember this, first of all, the difference between this and this is only gonna be one shade, medium brown, light brown. You wouldn't even probably, it wouldn't be so noticeable. But what I do is when I get right up to the part that has the other color is I do this. I just kind of like feather them together with my finger, because what you're creating is a diffused line, darker roots, lighter mid-lengths, and then a little bit of a blendy area in the middle that is a combination of the two. So it'll look kind of like medium, medium light, light. And remember, I'm going all over darker. It doesn't really bother me if lightness on one part starts a little higher, starts a little lower. That's pretty, that's dimensional. I'm cool with that. That's how my hair would be fading in the sun anyway. It's never gonna be the same everywhere. So I wanna show you what I'm saying kind of slowed down. So here's the hair against my glove. The dark color really only goes to right there. And so I'm gonna take, can you see that? Can everybody see what I'm doing well?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, so I'm gonna go all the way down to my ends. And then I find that if you do your emulsifying with your fingers, at the bottom first, it's helpful because you can catch the bits that fall like that. Okay, so here I go. I'm getting right to that area and I'm just gonna do this. Give it a little blend on both sides. Create a nice little diffused line. I promise, keep your eye on this when you get the after photo. We send the after photo in a follow-up email. You'll get it, I think, tomorrow. You won't see. There will be no like dark white. It'll be very soft. So I promise you can do this. Okay, Susan, go ahead.
No, Siobhan, I'm really glad you brought that up because I think, you know, when you go to a salon, one of the things that you'll notice your hairdresser doing is really working that color into the hair. And that is one of the top tips, the best secrets that we can give you, because working the color in means that you'll always get a nice even result and you get the maximum conditioning benefits that way as well, don't you, Siobhan?
Mm-hmm. And healthy hair is always the hair that's gonna look the prettiest. You can have great color on your hair and if it's not shiny, looking moisturized and happy, it's not gonna, no one's gonna ask where you get your color, right? So we always wanna think integrity of the hair first, it really matters.
And I just like to point out something that you are doing kind of unconsciously. We always work moving down towards the ends of the hair. So even though Siobhan's starting at the ends of her hair, she is working from the roots to the points. And that's the way that you really encourage your hair to look most shiny. Okay, so I'm gonna go for one more question before we go to processing. And what I'd like to do is ask Julie, let's see, Julie Nelson, I'm gonna ask to unmute you, my darling. And I'd like you to ask your question, Julie. Where are you?
Yes, I'm right here. Can you hear me?
Yes, I absolutely can.
Yes, well, thank you. But she already answered my question. I was wondering when you actually started the timer, and you did. You said 35 minutes from when you're done with the roots until you're complete, correct?
Yes,
yeah. Absolutely. And let's say too, if you didn't want your ends to get too much darker at all, let's say you just wanted to shade them, you could even set, you know, do your roots, set your timer, wait 10 more minutes, and then put that color on. My hair fades fast. I'm in the sun and salt water a lot, so I know it's gonna lighten, so I'm gonna go with as much processing. So at this point, I only have 20 left, right? Because it took me, I did it slow, I showed you guys how I went, that was already 15 minutes. So 20 minutes is all this is going to sit on there, and then I'm going to wash it all out together. And we give you these color removing wipes in your kit. These are amazing. These are from heaven. Don't throw this away or think it's just some extra. You really want this. The longer color sits on your skin, the more likely it is to stain. So as you're doing your filler, keep this handy and just get the little drippies as you go. You can feel around the back of your neck. They're also great for like your sink and floor, which I need to be doing right now because I had some drips.
Excellent, Siobhan. And then you're going to pop the plastic cap on.
You got it. Okay, so plastic cap. Also, please don't think that this is just an extra to be tossed or thrown away. This is really cool, not only because then you can go sit on your couch and like watch Netflix while you process, but when you put the cap on, it helps trap the heat of your scalp and helps your gray get covered. So you know how sometimes at a salon they'll put you under a heater? You're not going to do that at home, and you shouldn't. You should not process permanent color with heat, just so you know. But, you know, do the natural heat of your scalp. Be neat about this and put this just at the hairline, not across here. Because what happens is 45 minutes after this, your hair color has like melted onto your forehead and you have a black band. So just be kind to yourself. Put the cap right on the hairline. Okay, I'm done.
Perfect. Thank you, Siobhan. Now, we're going to come back to Siobhan because I'm sure that we've got more questions. But what I'd like to do right now is to perhaps use the time that we are processing to really good effect. Because Elizabeth Denton, who is Star Carter's beauty writer, has got a few ideas about how we can broadcast a new look to the whole wide world in a very simple way and actually easier than you perhaps might think. So, Elizabeth, I'd like to ask you to take the floor now, my dear, and tell us exactly what you've got to tell us.
Okay, great. So we're going to be making a TikTok transformation. So it sounds way more difficult than it is. I'm not a video editor. I'm a writer. I'm a journalist. I don't have the software. I don't have the video skills. All I have is my phone, and I can still create a really cool before, middle, and after to really show friends, families, whoever follows you on any of the social media platforms about how you got this cool look. And so you can just have fun with it and share with your friends. So first, I think we're gonna see a video that I've done in the past on my own TikTok. This is at a salon, but it's very similar what you're gonna do at home. It doesn't matter where you are. This is just an example that you're going to want to show the entire processing moment, all of the less cute, silly, crazy hair moments of getting your transformation.
When you said it was over, you shot right through my heart. Why you let these hoes tear what we had right apart? Oh, I was so mad. I could have seen this coming right from the start. You should beware, beware, beware. Love a woman with a broken heart.
Okay, so there's just a quick example. I actually wish that it's very short. I actually wish I showed more of the processing time. But when you're in a salon, especially with a mask, there's not that much that you can do and you can't move around so much. But when you're at home, you can show so much more of the process. So I'm going to quickly walk you through a very, very easy tutorial that you don't need to know anything complicated to do. And if you have any questions, of course, ask them. And then the cool thing is when you're done with it in TikTok, you can download it and you can share it on Instagram. You can upload it to Facebook just like you would upload a photo. You can share it with your friends and family and everyone can see your transformation. Okay, are you ready? Okay, so first you're gonna pull up the TikTok app and you're gonna see a plus sign right at the bottom. Now you don't have to worry, you can see my apartment. So now you don't have to worry about anything broadcasting, nothing is live, nothing is being posted. Do not worry, you can always backtrack, you can delete, you can do things over, you can do sections over. You can save it as a draft and post it next month if you wanted to. It's all up to you. So nothing you do in this system is going out to anyone, just you. So don't worry about that. So first of all, you're gonna make sure that at the bottom, it says 60 seconds. Now, of course you can do a 15 second video, but 15 seconds moves really fast when you wanna show some fun stuff. So go to the 60 second video right there. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna pick a song. So you're gonna go up to the top and hit add sound. Now, your TikTok will do the best and people will like it and share it and comment. If it's a really fun, upbeat song, maybe something that's trending, something that's all on the radio, but you don't have to really know what's cool right now. TikTok will help you decide what you should do. So you can see TikTok is already recommending me a couple, I think the screen might be a little bright, but a couple options. So it's telling me like, this would be a fun song. This would be a fun song. You can go to the bottom, you can click TikTok viral and you can see what songs are going viral right now. So I'm gonna pick Olivia Rodrigo's Good For You because I know that that's the Billboard number one song right now. And I want people to interact with my video. And I want people to be like, oh, I love this song. I wanna watch. So I'm just gonna click that. It's already starting to play. You can listen to it and make sure that's what you want us to do. And then you just press. And then you can see at the top, I have a song selected. So that, I mean, honestly, that's the hardest part. And then the rest of the time, you're just going to record yourself. Now, I would love to see, when I watch a transformation like this, I wanna see the ugly parts of the transformation. I wanna see the dripping. I wanna see how you're able to take that little cloth and wipe away and get like a perfect, you have no dye on your face, your hair looks great, you look a little funny in your bathroom. I wanna see the whole process. Those are the things that perform the best. Now, TikTok is an app that people use to show their real life, where other apps are a little bit more stylized and pretty and perfect. You can be messy on TikTok. People like that. People interact with that. They have fun with that. So show how you're sectioning your hair. You can show how you kind of feel like a hairstylist doing this at home by yourself and show off how you're doing it. How maybe you can also show the product, show the color you're using, you know, get people excited to see your final look. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna press the red button, which is record, and you're gonna hold it down. And then at the top is where your seconds go. So you're gonna wanna just hold it down. It'll play the music. And you let go. And then you can see at the top, okay, so this is how much I've used. And now you wanna think about, so if you have, say you have, it doesn't have to be perfect. You're not a video editor. Maybe you are, but I'm not. So you're gonna leave maybe 5 to 10 seconds left at the end because you wanna have enough time to show your look off. You don't wanna get to the point where you showed so much that you have nothing left. I tend to get carried away showing my cat, showing things, and then realize I have 2 seconds left to show my look. So don't do that, pay attention. So look at the top, make sure that you have a little bit of time left and show things, show your cat, show you applying makeup, show that you're making dinner and you're able to like wear this funny hat in the kitchen. Show, sometimes I go on the patio with my hair half up, show the real life because that's what people wanna see. And then you're just gonna keep recording. Now, you can add music at the end, but the reason why I like adding music before so that you can hear it while you're recording is because I think it's fun to, now you don't have to like sing along to the music. I mean, you can if you want, but you don't have to. I like just using the music as a guide of when to stop and start. It kind of gives you an idea of sections. So maybe when the music's ramping up, that's when you want to show your finished product, or maybe when the music's a little slower, that's when you want to do like a 360 of your bathroom. Whatever you want to do, it's totally up to you. And I promise at the end, when it all comes together, it looks professional, even though you probably spent 10 minutes all together on it. So you just want to keep going. When you get to the end, you'll have the entire blue line will finish at the top. You'll show your finished look. You can do like a whole 360. You can show off your hair. You can show off the color. And then that's it. Then you'll press the plus sign. You can watch yourself. You can watch it a million times if you want to. You can always go back and delete certain sections. If you're like, the back of my hair looks crazy, let me do that again. You can just delete that section, record it again. We do it all the time. You constantly re-record if you want to. And then you press next. It's always red. Everything's always red. So then you press next. You can describe your video if you want. You can put anything you can want. You can put, you know, watch my Madison Reed hair transformation, watch me go from blonde highlights to fully brunette, anything you want. And then you press post. And that's it. It's out there into the world. Anybody can watch it. And then if you, you know, if you don't have a lot of TikTok followers, if a lot of your friends aren't on TikTok, then post it to Facebook, post it to Instagram, post it anywhere you want to post it so that people can comment, like, follow you, and just interact with it and have a, you know, have fun with it. So, well, yeah. Any questions, please ask away. It sounds complicated, but I promise it's not.
Well, Elizabeth, thank you for demystifying that, because that is something that I have to say, I've never used TikTok. My children use it, and I've seen other people use it, and I've never even thought about doing it. So you've kind of given me a little bit of an insight into how to do it, and I must say I'm now quite curious.
Just like doing here at home.
I have questions for Elizabeth. She's going to hang around and be available to us, just like Siobhan still is. And Siobhan, how are you doing?
I'm great. And Elizabeth, thank you so much, because I'm a big like before and after still picture taker, but I know like the kids these days, right? Like if people, you know, nobody wants to see your still photo. Everybody's like, show me something a little bit more animated. The most important thing that you said that whole time is if it sucks, you can delete it. That's what I need to know.
You don't have to ever post it. You can keep it for yourself. You can save it and just for the friends. You can do whatever you want with it.
We can rethink it. Now, I'd like to ask Tara, because I know, Tara, you've been waiting patiently, my darling, to ask your question. And I can see you're still there. So I'm going to ask to unmute you, and you will be able to ask Siobhan and I whatever you have to ask us. Are you there, my love?
Hi, Tara.
Yes. Hi. Had some technical problems, so I may have missed a little bit of your demo. And I have a lot of questions, but one of the most pressing questions is, I've been, you know, binging on all kinds of hairstylists, YouTube videos, and everybody has their own technique, work one way, work the opposite way. But one of the things that seems consistent and has also stopped me from going forward, even after buying color, it's still sitting on my counter, is toner. And so you haven't mentioned, as far as I know, toner. And so everybody talks about how, whether you do it the way that you did it with two different colors or an overall color that turns out brassy, or like I'm all brass right now and I've got a lot of gray, like maybe I've never been brave enough to figure out how much gray, but I would estimate I'm close to 75% gray. And so, you know, I've got gray and I've got dark. And then I've got this blonde. I've always been a blonde, but now I'm just getting darker and gray. So whenever I've had color done professionally, which has been a long time, they've always said, oh, well, we're gonna put in a toner, because I'm like mortified when I see myself in the mirror after I get out of the sink. Mm-hmm. They're like, oh, don't worry, we're gonna put on a toner. I never understood what toner was until recently, watching all these videos, realizing
such a good question.
Demi color. But yeah, with this technique that you used, wouldn't somebody still need a toner?
Like, Susan, can I answer
like,
it?
Yes, like, go wears for it. Out as the color okay. kind of.
Okay, so toners, you want to think of toners as color maintenance. So once my color is right, I'm going to use toner to maintain it, right? What I was explaining earlier was, today, what I need is I need all over color because I need more deposit. So I am using permanent color, but Tara, I'm only doing this once. I'm going to run the permanent color that I want through my ends this one time. And then in 4 weeks, let's be real, 6 weeks when I actually get around to it, and I do my roots with permanent, then I'm going to use toner on the mid lengths and ends. So toners are either semi or demi permanent colors that don't get in as far into the cortex. For those of you who might not be in the toner world, they're gentler, softer, easier colors. So hair color, this is like lipstick, and toners are like lip gloss. Coverage, toning, gloss, shine, you can see through it. So yes, absolutely. My next thing that I'm going to do in 6 weeks is root coverage and then toner to refresh the ends. So toner is when you don't need to drastically change it. You're just adjusting the tone and adding shine. So that's a great question, because usually I would be using a root and a toner? So you nailed, that was a great question. And also we are going to give an email address at the end of this segment that links directly to me. And if you happen to have any specific questions about color matching to a Madison Reed toner or gloss, I can totally help you with that via email too. So please do reach out, because that'd be great to chat with you about that.
Well, so I don't know if I'm muted. Am I muted?
No, we can hear you.
Oh, okay. So, you know, I also understand that it can be used to kind of touch up color or refresh it, but I've seen a lot in my experiences whenever I'm done with permanent color out of the box at home, the whole nightmare situation, I'm never really happy with it. Like it just goes from brass to brassier and even it just gets worse. And so if I were to choose a color, a Madison Reed color, and then apply it, and I'm like, oh, this didn't work out, would I then just put toner over it right away? Or like, is there a correction for that? I mean, I've gone to the, you know, the drugstore and I see all these, like one of them is actually called Color Oops. And it's supposed to take color out. And
yeah,
I've never gone that far to say, okay, I want to remove all my color. Cause I don't, I worry that that would just damage my hair more and be like making a bad decision worse. But what do you do when, you know, you select the wrong Madison Reed color and it's, you know, an hour after you put it on and you're not happy, then what can you do?
Tara, first of all, I'd like to put your mind at rest. Okay. I can tell that you're quite worried about this whole scenario. And what I would like to tell you is that at Madison Reed, we work very hard at helping people like you. So help is at hand. All you need to do is go to the website, go through the questionnaire and see if that helps to clarify things for you. Also try not to overthink it. There are people on hand that can help. And also at the end of the house party, and that's why we do this, because we love connecting with people, you will have an email address that you can actually send your specific question to. And here's the deal. There's lots of different ways to do it. And hairdressers may give you different advice. You will find that we'll get you the simplest possible way. And yes, there's always something you can do, because until you cut your hair off, there's always a solution. And I've been coloring hair for a really long time. And I can tell you that we can always adjust. We can easily make darker. We can even go lighter if need be. So, and it really just does depend on where your hair is coming from and what it's experienced, as well as where you want to go. And that's why we're here, because it isn't the straightforward answer that you would automatically think it to be.
Well, I've ordered color. I've used Madison Reed before and just kind of didn't think about it. That's before I even knew what brassy was. And I ended up with brassy hair, but probably I was doing something wrong. I didn't have, you know, the right shampoo, et cetera, et cetera. But I would like to know that I can have somebody actually look at the color and not trust my description.
And you absolutely
that's good to know.
And we just added video chat too.
Yes.
So you can do that in real time. And yes,
that's
it's amazing.
The best.
And I also want to say, just for everyone who's watching, because this information could be good for everybody, we have 100% satisfaction guarantee at Madison Reed. So you buy something and you don't love it, we will figure it out with you. If we need a color sort of remover, we have one called Prime for Perfection. It's gentle, it's beautiful, you'll love it, it's easy. We can send you a toner. If you spend $26 with us, we're going to make sure you get $26 worth of a solution. So I promise, you know, and everyone who answers the phone, does live chat, does email, those are all licensed cosmetologists.
Okay.
So anyone that you're video chatting with or emailing with, they are licensed colorists who know this color inside and out. So they'll definitely help you. You won't have that feeling like when you're at the drugstore and you're like, oh my goodness, like nobody's helping me. What do I do?
When Madison Reed just first started, that's when I bought it. And so that was a long time ago. And I didn't realize that you had all these features that you've added. So I appreciate knowing that.
Awesome. Thank you, Tara.
Thank you, Tara. One more thing.
Hey, Susan, before you, I know we have a winner to announce for our color contest. I wanted to throw in one little note for everyone coloring their hair at home. One thing that I do is I put down a piece of parchment paper or wax paper, foil, whatever. And then when all of your, you know, work is done, then you can just pick this whole thing up and then toss this, and you're not getting drips on your kitchen counter. So I forgot to tell you that I had done this, but I had done this. So I'm gonna now do my very quick cleanup and let Susan announce our contest winner. But yeah, do this, it'll make your life better.
Thank you, Siobhan. And from beginning to end, she's always got the answer. So you will see Siobhan's hair. We will see that by email. If you have questions that are burning and you need to be answered, and Tara, I think you're one of those people, make sure that you send those questions to us at the email you'll see right at the end. Today, we have a winner. And this person will be having a consultation from one of our Madison Reed colorists and will receive the perfect color for them. And our winner is Maritza Diaz. So well done to Maritza. You need to reach out to us, Maritza, and let us know that you're our winner, and we will make sure that we get your color to you. I'd like to also thank very much Elizabeth Denton from STYLECASTER for joining us. Use her tips to show off your next hair color transformation. And the party continues. We are going to be doing this again on June 9th, where we're going to be showing you how you can maintain your gorgeous color that you have managed to achieve by using the perfect pair. That's Madison Reed Radiant Cream Color on your roots and then Color Reviving Gloss on your ends. So thank you so much. More special guests, more tint hits and tricks. And we'd love to see you next time. Thank you and good night from Madison Reed and from Dallas.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.